This is Hyder Ali Sayyad from Asivagam, united under Tamil Shiva.
While Shia Kamal Wasim Rizvi filed a PIL in the Supreme Court asking Supreme Court for the removal of the 26th verse from Quran which talks about jihad. The problem with 1.8 billion collectively called Shia, Sunni, Sufi, Wahhabi followers is that they don't know the message of Quran. A so-called Muslim are blind followers of their ulama, Maulana, Alim and its school of thought of anti-spiritual regime. Prophet Muhammad, the last messenger, followed the school of thought of first Siddha, Tamil Shiva. Madarsa, they don't teach Quran, which leads to the straight part of first Siddha, Tamil Shiva. I repeat, Madarsa doesn't enlighten people with the message of the Quran. Madarsa do not want a balanced system, but they want to suppress the message of the Quran so that they can end God's spiritual part. Remember, Madarsa is serving the anti-spiritual regime, which Bible Daniel chapter 7 refers as four beastly regime. Quran motivates the son of soil to unite and rise against the anti-spiritual regime and its policy. Quran motivating children of soil to wage war against anti-spiritual regime of Caucasian settlers now disguised as Muslim world. Set the balance is the teaching of the Holy Quran, but we find Muslim cult are the root cause of all evil, causing the disbalance, and they are a nuisance in the society. Quran has got nothing to do with Shia, Sunni, Sufi, Wahhabi. Quran never entertains them. Quranic verses never mention Shia, Sunni, Sufi, Wahhabi in it. Who is Wasim Rizvi? Wasim Rizvi is a Shia from Persian clan, and Quran does not entertain Shia or Persian clan. Please open Quran, read it yourself with understanding. When you read Quran, you'll come across terms like people of the book and children of Israel. The question is, who are the people of the book and where are they today? A first Siddha, in other words, first human with all information whom God thought by pen as mentioned in Quran chapter 96, 1 to 5. Who is that man with all information including Kama Sastra? Yes, the first man with all information on all subjects is Tamil Shiva Alai Seth. People of the book mentioned in the Quran refers to the bloodline of first Siddha, Tamil Shiva and his black colony across Akhand Bharat. This is the main reason why Tamil king of Kerala responded to Prophet Muhammad on witnessing the splitting of the moon. Second term mentioned in Quran is children of Israel. And the question is, who are they and where are they today? Children of Israel are from the bloodline of Ibrahim of Semitic black race. They are under the Quran. Children of Israel now a scattered nation. Bible says, Quran confirms in chapter 17 verse 104 about the final exodus of children of Israel as promised to them by Allah. Currently, children of Israel ancestral land is occupied by Caucasian settlers now disguised as the Muslim world. Other terms mentioned in Quran are Jew, Christian and Muslim. Jew, Christian and Muslim are faith, and faith is unseen. Each term has its definition, which we would deal in a future video. Further, Quran says in chapter 49 verse 13 to identify by race and tribe. Who is the Muslim world by race and tribe? Muslim world by DNA is Caucasian settlers from the bloodline of Cain. Cain, the first anti-spiritual man. Tamil Krishna warns about greater Kali Yuga. Bible warns about the coming of Antichrist alias Messiah the Dajjal. Muslim world is the settlers from the bloodline of Cain, the first anti-spiritual man. All prophet had warned regarding the coming of Messiah the Dajjal. Remember, people who rejected Prophet Muhammad's invitations were Roman Persian Empire and the hypocrites among the natives who are serving the secret society. Why there is a need for the secret society to file a petition in the Supreme Court against those 26 verses of the Quran deals with war jihad through a Shia called Wasim Rizvi. Remember, Persian Empire, Roman Empire, they were once a superpower. They persecuted the black Tamil colonies in Indus Valley, Iranian Plateau, Kashmir. They further waged war against Ibrahim bloodline of Semitic black race. Bible Daniel chapter 7 called those Caucasian settlers as beastly regime. Remember, it was Quran during the period of Prophet Muhammad which united the black natives. This unity of black resulted in the collapse of the settlers regime, Roman Empire and Persian Empire. The four beastly regime mentioned in Bible, Daniel chapter 7 and their cult are as follows. Shia are associated with Persian Empire, Sunni is associated with Roman Empire, Sufi is associated with third beastly regime, Ottoman Empire, Wahhabism is associated with fourth and final beastly regime of Satan Saudi. We are about to enter Satya. We are going to witness the final exodus. We are going to witness the second coming of Jesus. Caucasian settlers now disguised as the Muslim world are fearing that their anti-spiritual regime is going to end very soon. Remember, Quran ended Roman Empire, Persian Empire during the period of Prophet Muhammad. Third beastly regime, Ottoman Empire collapsed due to world war. The fourth beast, Satan Saudi, the end is very close. The message of the Quran exposes the secret society called Mithraism alias Illuminati. which is now headed by Caucasian settlers, fourth and final baseline regime of Satan Saudi under New World Order. So before Quran could end them, the secret society wants to destroy Quran, which motivates native to end settlers' priestly regime. So secret society, which no longer is a secret society, through Wasim Rizvi, a Shia has sown a seed against Quran, so in near future they can remove those verses from Quran and thus save their beastly regime and save their anti-spiritual cult of Shia, Sufi, Sunni, Wahhabi and other evil groups. Quran leads to straight part of first Siddha Tamil Shiva. Nandri Vanakkam.